Hi friends, my today's topic is correlation receiver. So correlation receiver, this is having two term, receiver and correlation. So those receiver basically depends upon correlation function to receive the signals, actually called the correlation receiver. So here, what are the technicalities we are following? So if signals do not have equal energy, we can use that d of x. Here d is a decision rule, d of x equals to arg max pointed bracket s I comma x inside outside the pointed bracket minus half e of I first bracket closed. So this is to implement the ML rule. So here the receiver is coherent because the receiver requires to be in perfect synchronization with the transmitter. More specifically, the integration must begin at exactly the right time instances. So the receiver is coherent. Why? Because the receiver requires to be in the perfect synchronization with the transmitter. The integration must begin at exactly the right time instance. So if you are delaying the integration to start either the later or before the right time, so there will be some delay will be created inside that particular constellation diagram or in that signal space, you can say, and that delay will create much more error. So the vector representation is not enough to equalize this thing. So the receiver has to be coherent before this. Now here that circuit entirely represents how that correlators and integrators are working. Here you can see the left section of that particular diagram, you can see that XT is basically taken a different shape of F1, F2, F3 and F4 up to FN multiplier circuit. And each and every multiplier circuit is basically using that XT to multiply it with that F1, F2 up to FN, and therefore all the output is XF1T, XF2T, XF3T. In this way they are integrating, we see, because they are integrating of 0 to T. So first of all we should take some basis, and regarding this basis we have to represent that entire signal into the vector space. And one signal having different component of the vector space, like just like x1, x2, x3, x4. So one xt is basically the summation of this. So when it is multiplying with that f1t, obviously that output is coming as x1, because the OB has been created and we are multiplying. It means we are doing the dot product of that f2, f1 and fnt with that xt. So therefore the x1 itself, the x2 itself, the xn itself snatched out from that particular one. Now one important factor you should notice, that the input signal here is XT, but the output signal X1, X2, X3, XN up to in this way. So where the T has gone, the T has been sampled out. So inside that particular one, when this is multiplied with that second term, so it is also XT and FT. But when this is XT and FT are multiplied, so obviously one correlation function is used inside. So when their multiplication is integrated out with that region of 0 to T, so obviously one particular value is coming which is independent of T. Therefore the output of XT multiplied with F1T having integrated of 0 to T with respect to DT will give that only single value of X1. So in the same way, that x2, x1, x3 up to xn, these values are being created. So this particular section is called the demodulator, the decoder circuit. Now in that next part, when it is passes to the next part, you can see that here that x is subdivided between this region up to this region. So each and every one is again multiplied with that S value. It means the predefined or the known value or the known level of the signal is multiplied with their particular x value. So when it is multiplied, so it is finally taken to the accumulator, which will be storing that value, and finally that accumulator is passing the value to a particular summer, in which it is summed with that half E1, that is the energy spectra of that particular given signal. Okay, so here each and every one, S1, S2, S3, S4, in this way, when you are multiplying this, so all these individual results are stored in that particular device, which will select the largest value from this particular cases. So here, whatever the largest value is being selected, so the final output is that estimate of M. Here, very important point one is this: what is the estimation and how to estimate? The estimation is nothing but to get the exact value which is being expected. Now, how to get that? Actually, the different values when x1, x2, x3, x4 are being created of the demodulator, the decoder circuit, that next part is nothing but multiplication of that x1 with that s. Now, that s is basically the part of x which is corrupted with w. So initially we wrote that x equals to s plus w. Here, when x is again multiplied with s, so obviously it should have some previous value in that s1, s2, s3, s4 in this level. These all are separated out. Now, after the multiplication, when the value is taken inside that accumulator, so all these values are equally judged to select the largest one. So which one is the largest, the other one is taken accordingly just after it. So finally we can get one particular shape of the signal, and therefore this particular shape of the signal is called the product or the result of the estimation. So this particular device is used to estimate M. So that is the whole how one correlation receiver is working inside that circuit. Now here it is a output that we are taking from the matched filter. Here in this particular output, the demodulator, the decoder circuit is used. Here the match filter is used. So what is a match filter? In that match filter is basically one delta function is there inside that particular body. So whenever the delta function is there, so actually here just imagine that in a match filter how it works. So in a match filter there is different term of the delta function like this. So one signal is passing, when that signal is passing to this particular one, okay, so that delta function is representing. When the signal is passing to that function, so this function is representing. Maybe the signal is not passing to that next delta function, it is touches the second one, so this one will be crossed, this one tick, and this one tick. So finally in this way each and every samples are passed to that match filter, and that particular matched filter is basically doing the matching of that impulses already that is appending to it, and on impulses is there inside that particular filter. So when these two filter impulses only, it means that the external impulses and the filter impulses, when matched, then only it will produce one output, that is x1. So if the first filter matches, it will produce x1. If the second filter matches, it will produce x2. In this way x1, x2, x3, x4 up to xn will be created for the sample point t equals to capital T right here. So in the second half, the same thing will be done as we have already discussed in the decision maker circuit. So in the decision maker circuit, these values are again multiplied with that S1, S2 up to SM. Now this individual multiplication are stored inside that accumulator and that accumulator values are there, which is ranging from the smallest to the largest. So you have to get the largest value, it means the largest amplitude value has to be selected out to estimate M cap, and that is a particular circuitry concept, or that is a particular diagram of that circuit is not a actual circuit diagram, it is called the schematic diagram. So in that particular schematic diagram, I have shown that how one filter can be used as a decoder of the integrated circuit. This is called the matched filter, or instead of the matched filter, you can use that demodulator, the detector circuit, like here. So this portion is called that correlation receiver, where that matched filter is used. Okay, so in the next portion, that is equivalence of correlation matched filter receivers. So the correlator and the matched filter can be made equivalent. So what I have told earlier, that two circuits, two equivalent circuit is being presented in front of you. There two things are being shown. One is done with that one, this thing said, the thing is done usually by using one decoder circuit. In the other half, it is done with that matched filter, and I have shown how the decoder and the matched filter is working together. Now the correlator and the matched filter can be made as equivalent. So specially here, x of I equals to integration 0 to t x t or x tau f I t dt, that is equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x tau h of t minus tau d tau. So here this particular one is representing the correlation function. So now this correlation function can be represented in a tabular way, where you have get a lot of x tau value, where you will be getting a lot of h t minus tau value. So these values, when individually multiplied or dotted and taking as a summation over the range of minus infinity to plus infinity, so this is basically representing in that pattern that is somehow written in that form of x tau cross h of t minus tau in this way. So this particular function is this. So this is a correlation function. So the correlator and the matched filter can be made as equivalent. Okay, specially this function is known to you, and if h of I t equals to f of f I t minus tau, if it is represented, then the same formula can be represented out. So one impulse function, if is being created for f I of capital T minus t, so implicitly f I t is 0 outside that 0 to t domain. It means if t is lying between 0 to capital T domain, so f I t is just 0 outside the domain. So whenever and whatever you have to calculate that value of h I t, that f I t must falling in that range of 0 to capital T, otherwise it is not possible. So that's all for my today's class. In the next class, we'll be going much more deeper of this particular signal space. Thank you very much for listening all my classes. See you all in my next class. Thank you very much.